So my name is Tomek Szymański. I'll be talking about building relationships in a remote environment. One disclaimer though to start with is that I do not consider this forced isolation as a normal work from home situation. This is something that sucks and I am also tired with it even though I have a lot of experience with working remotely. So do not consider this as a typical remote working environment. But without further ado, so if I saw you, I'd ask to raise hands to anyone if you consider that remote work is a place where you cannot build relationships. And what I would like to talk about is how we do it and what can you do about to have these relationships built in the remote working environment. The reason I'm talking to you is that I am a remote worker for 15 years now. But more importantly, I have founded Software Mill over 10 years ago, which was a remote company from day one, and we haven't had an office ever. So we work from whole Poland. We have 65 people on board right now. We work on 14 projects around the world. And last year we had 60 million turnover. So we're not a very small company anymore. And the team has grown and there's some experience I'd like to share. So what do we do? First thing is that we simulate an office, even though Paweł said it's immature environment. I don't consider it immature. We use the tools that you probably know and use already, so Slack, Team, and so on. But what I'd like to talk about is the bits and pieces we use from them to maintain strong relationships between our workers. So Slack, obviously you use Slack for different things. You have your technical rooms, project rooms, etc. for the company communication. But what we really use it for also is the interest groups. So there are different rooms for different hobbies and for different life situations. And the list is also maintained on our wiki on Confluence so that you can check whatever is what is in the company and join one of those interest groups. So there's one for people with kids, without kids, with cat lovers, dog lovers, book lovers, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. There's over 40, I think, right now. And you just can find people with your shared hobbies so that you can basically have something on the side of just a typical work relationship. Second thing is TeamSpeak. How we do it is that there are rooms for every project and people have it set up and they basically sit in those rooms for most of the day so that when you want to talk to your peers, it's like sitting in the same room. You start talking by some key combination, push to talk, and they hear whatever you're saying. And that way you can also talk not only about the work, but there's room for those spin up kind of conversations when you can quickly discuss something. This is something Tomek talked about in his first talk. So this works quite well. Third thing I'd like to talk about is that people need to know the purpose. And when they know the purpose, they kind of feel more attached to whatever environment they are in. So onboarding is crucial. What we did is we have this Software Mill handbook. You can download it online. It tells you about the first days, weeks, and months at Software Mill, and it shows you basically what you're gonna be doing, plus some tips on remote work that helps. Now, if we were not in the Corona situation, there are meetings which are super important. One thing you can still do is the everyday meeting on video. We have a status for top 30 minutes. It's more to catch up, see how everyone's doing and basically what's going on at the company. Very important that everyone is on their cameras so you can see people and you can feel attached and you can feel that humanity between you and your peers. Then once a month, we also have the meetings that in flesh. Super important. I couldn't live without those. Unfortunately, now we have to live without those. So what can you do about your meeting other people and spending time with them during the Corona times? We did an online party. I wrote a blog about it. I'll post it in the chat, which went quite surprisingly well. We spent many hours together just having fun. Very, very nice. Also, there's lots of things that are available for years now. So there's card games, board games, there's online games. You can do reading clubs. on Zoom like we do now. You can do technical presentations like we do now. So I think it's crucial during the corona times that people feel and have the feeling that the business is as usual. So everyone just goes, everything just goes as it used to be. So think about the little things you had in your office before. How can you translate them to online? And the last tip I have is we have one of the projects, they have something called tea time. Every day 2:25, there's a notification on Slack with pre-generated hangout meeting. You just enter it with your tea or coffee, and it's a time like in the office you would go to the kitchen to talk about all the things you talk about, not necessarily work. So there's a room for that. So we simulate an office, we give opportunity to spend time together, then we profit. And that is all I wanted to tell you. Thank you very much.